Hi Pisces, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and today we're going to do a love read for you. Let's see how you're feeling, Pisces, how your person is feeling, and what action we can expect in this connection. And these are general collective readings, Pisces, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind, take what works for you, and leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Pisces and send them the messages they need to hear the most for their love life now. Thank you. All right, Pisces, let's start your reading. Welcome back, all my subscribers. Thank you for your patience. And yes, I'm still unsettled. My furniture and stuff still hasn't arrived at my new place, but it doesn't really matter, does it? We'll do it when it comes. And newbies, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us, we welcome you in. So newcomers, I'm setting down two sets of cards here. One side is for you, one side is for your person, and in the center I'm going to have your dialogue message cards, action cards, etc. But for the duration of this reading, Pisces, this side is person A for me, this side is person B for me. If this is your reading, you'll know which side you resonate best with, right? So bottom of my deck, I have the Three of Wands. Maybe there's a lot of waiting going on. Let's see. So from what I'm seeing here, Pisces, yes, there is a lot of delay happening, leaving one person very confused as to what are you waiting for? Maybe Christmas, but that's also around the corner. The other person is kind of feeling a little depressed for some reason. They do want to get out of this phase. They're feeling very ungrounded, maybe not feeling stable in their own life for some reason. And maybe their own circumstances have put them there, but the other person is feeling very confused about it. Hey, what's the delay? Why don't you come forward? I've been waiting for you to say something. So let's start, Pisces, let's start with some dialogue message cards here. Let's see if you guys could say something to each other, what that would be, and then we'll clarify the rest of the cards. So Pisces and their person spirit, they could say something to each other now. What would that be? Pisces and their person. Oops, I've got the wrong deck. This one. No wonder it wasn't coming out, and I was wondering why aren't they popping out here, see? Spirit knows which decks to use. Alright, one more. Okay, and I'm going to take a few more Pisces from another deck. Pisces and their person. Alright. Okay, good to go, Pisces. Let's start your reading. The first card here says, I act like I don't care, but deep down, it affects me more than you'll ever know. And the other person is confused because they just see what is being shown to them, right? That my person doesn't care for me. Left off on bad terms with so many things left unsaid. I got a whiff of your scent. It made me smile remembering you. I really didn't think we were compatible at first. I see that we are now. I have faith that we'll be together again. I'm holding space for you. Somebody is waiting. I imagine the type of person you'd want to be with, and that person is nothing like me. I can't wait to lay my head on your chest and listen to your heartbeat. All right, Pisces, these were some of the messages. Now we're going to start our reading, but of course before that, an angel blessing card. Let's see what my angels have for you today. My angels, blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Pisces. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message. Blessings of abundance. Pisces, congratulations. I think you're going to come into some goodies, it seems. And it could be money. It could be lots of money. Maybe you're getting something that you deserve. And yes, so this is like a reward from the universe. And when I see this card, it's just not finances and money. It's so much beyond that. Look at this person with all the fruits and lovely things, or, you know, just gifted. The grapes and the apples. And this is like having abundance, mental, physical, emotional, in love, financial, all kinds of abundance. And maybe it's your time to receive now, Pisces. Make sure you receive it with open arms. Be open to receiving now. All right, so I'm sorry, my stand hasn't come yet, so I'm still stuck. Can you see this? Okay, because this is a beautiful card. I want it on screen. Yes, I think you can see it. All right, so okay, let's start with the energies of person A, Pisces. You could be either side, right? For me, this is person A, this is person B, and right now I'm going to concentrate only on one side, which is person A. So person A, Four of Cups in reverse. Why do you feel that way? Four of Cups in reverse. I think, Pisces, whoever person A is, I think in the past was holding back. They may have walked away from a very strong connection, but now they feel quite sad and depressed because they feel all those mind games that I played, eventually now I realize that I was bringing the toxicity in. I want to get over all that. The stress and tension is killing me now because I feel I walked away from a soulmate or a very strong connection. They're feeling they made a mistake, let me put it this way. So why do you feel like the King of Pentacles in reverse, person A? They feel like the King of Pentacles in reverse because now they're recognizing, oh my God, I didn't think we were compatible at first, but I do now. I see the person B to be my happily ever after. Now they do want to repair the damage, they do want to kind of get over any addictions or anything wrong that they were doing or anything that had come between this connection. But they could be a little worried that their person is now holding back from them or has emotionally maybe walked away from them, and that's kind of depressing, person A. They're not feeling grounded at all, with knowing that, you know, maybe they've lost their person, but they don't want to. They don't want to live the rest of their life now in regret and sorrow and having lost the person who they now recognize to be their soulmate. So what happened, person A, in the recent past that you're feeling this way now? Ace of Wands in reverse. They never took action when the time was right. Maybe they waited too long, or they came across as a promise breaker, heartbreaker, a flirt, who kind of sings the same song and takes the same wine to about 100 different people. So maybe they didn't take action in one place where they should have, or they could have, or where they want to now, I guess. So this person, I think, broke a lot of hearts and broke promises. They didn't come across as anybody stable. But now, since then, I think they've been thinking about it. They've been enlightened to the fact that, hey, I don't want anyone else. I want a brand new beginning. I don't want any competition between us. I don't want any fighting between us. They're really wishing and hoping for this to end, this conflict to end. This enlightenment has come now, but they've already done the damage. They so want to now repair the damage, but they're a little depressed, wondering if they can ever, you know, manage that now. So what you have to do something, person A. What are you planning to do now? How do you see your person? What do you want to do? How do you feel about the connection? Well, person A says, Heart of hearts, I want to take them an offer of love. I still have romantic feelings towards them. I want to go and woo them. I want to go and romance them. So then what's the problem, person A? Why don't you do it? Knight of Cups. Because there's been a tower moment between the two of you. There's been something which kind of, maybe you guys had a fight, or maybe whatever happens between couples, you know, whatever happened in your situation, you would know why you guys broke up and how it could have been an abrupt change, abrupt ending. So then, yes, but they do want to communicate about it. They do want to talk, they want to communicate, they want to clear the air now. Look at this. I want to talk, I want to make things right, I want to communicate. That's what they want to do. So what's the justice card then, person A? What's the justice card? They are planning as to how to make things right now. Like, how do I bring justice into this equation? They could be, as you know, and they could be a little... Okay, so this person feels quite powerless at the moment. Maybe in the past they were a bit stubborn, but I don't feel they are anymore. This is more like, I've lost my power. How do I say this? Strength card in reverse, Emperor in reverse. Now they're feeling a little weak need to be able to go and do or say something. So they're kind of still in that mode of not taking action. They're still kind of trying to understand, they're trying to plan, they're trying to wonder how can I bring justice. Two cards. Justice was clarified by the justice card. So they really do want to do the right thing. But maybe they're feeling a little powerless because of their past mistakes and how they'll be judged probably. So they're still planning what to say, how to clear the air. So what action they'll finally take, I'll open later, Pisces. Let's go on to the other side and see what's happening here. So, person B, why do you have the Seven of Cups? Why are you confused? Because they've been waiting for that message. They've been waiting for an apology. They've been waiting for a message. And the more time is going by, it's kind of burdening them that, hey, I was expecting them to say something, apologize to me. And I've been standing here waiting. And that's kind of making me feel not that great now. Because I'm getting more and more confused. And yes. This person has been waiting. Person B has, I mean, if Pisces, you're on person B's side, you may not agree with me, but subconsciously, there's a part of you which probably has been waiting, at least for an apology, at least for a message. Because this has been very burdening for you, whatever's happened between the two of you. Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, somebody is feeling a little left out in the cold. Person B, I think. Person B has been waiting for something, anything from person A to show that they are still interested in a partnership or an equal give and take. But all they've got is this feeling of lack because person A still hasn't come forward, right? The delay is getting too much. And from what we saw of the other side, they do want to come, but they're nervous. They're nervous because they've created that tower moment in the past. So intentions are there, but they're still planning as to how to come forward. Meanwhile, person B is, I think, getting a little overwhelmed. So what happened, person B, in the recent past for you to be feeling this way? The Fool in reverse. Why is the Fool in reverse? Yes, no new beginning was offered. Person B ended up feeling like a fool because that person showed up as the Knight of Wands, somebody who was a player. We saw this here as well, right? The Knight of Cups in reverse. So somebody who's a player, who just wants to, you know, have fun with lots of people and never commit. So I think person B ended up feeling quite foolish for trusting or waiting around for a Knight of Wands. Knight of Wands sometimes is known as the player, right? And yes, they may have caught them with the Seven of Swords in reverse. For feeling very betrayed. I think what person B was expecting was something, an offer to be made of a future or stable brand new beginning. Instead, what they found out really, really devastated them because this is like feeling stabbed in the back multiple times. Part of them, I think, still waits for an apology or an explanation, but this waiting has gone on for too long because person A is still not taking action. So, person B, how do you see your person now? How do you see this connection? Person B says, well, I don't even want to fight for this connection anymore because, you know, the stagnancy has been too much for me. I've been waiting and waiting and waiting, and look at them, not even one foot in front of the other. It's stagnancy, and I'm tired of waiting. I'm giving up the fight, basically. One more, seven of wands. Yes, person B says, I would have liked a reunion if they had come towards me with love, but this little bit of time out that I've taken to heal myself, I think I'm ready to make a choice. I'm ready to make that decision and maybe go out and find a new love. Some of you could be actually keeping this a secret even from yourself, maybe. I don't know, from your friends or I don't know what. Somebody is kind of, after a lot of contemplation, maybe thinking of going out and interacting with new people, making a decision to... See, both these cards are decision. I make the choice. I want to find somebody who truly loves me and can show me. I think person B has one wish, which is uppermost in their mind, and which is to find a loving partner. I want somebody who can actually be loving and show me. Are you sure, person B? Is that what you want? Yeah, because person B says, I'm tired of being alone. I feel so ungrounded. My person never really showed me what I wanted in my life. I wanted to be respected. I wanted to be maybe their spouse or their partner, and they never really did it. I mean, it's time that I turn my back and start looking out for somebody else who can bring that commitment to me. So it's like a 50-50 with person B. Somewhere they still wait for that apology, but half their mind, because the waiting has been so long, is ready now to maybe meet new people. Alright, so let's see what actions you guys will take, Pisces. And since you guys are still here, can I request you for a like button, please? Just a thumbs up to let me know how many it's resonating with. Also helps the videos to circulate. That'll be really helpful. Thank you. And newbies, don't forget to push that notification bell when you subscribe so that YouTube can then inform you. Person A, why do you have the Chariot in reverse as your action? Why is the Chariot in reverse? Knight of Swords, Eight of Pentacles. One more. Temperance. One more. What's the action you're planning to take, person A? Page of Cups. Okay, so they are also they are also exhausted with this waiting, it seems. The blockages that have come between the two of you. They are coming in to apologize. Page of Cups with the Temperance card. Still being a little slow, I would say, a little impatient till now, but they are sure now that they want to work on this connection. In fact, forget the Chariot. They don't even want to wait for the horses. Look at this person, Knight of Swords. They're running to come and maybe apologize now. Person B, what about you? Six of Wands in reverse. Why do you feel that way? Why is the Six of Wands? They don't believe them. Six of Wands is like Nine of Cups. One more. Ace of Cups, my God. And the Justice card. I think... Well, just when I think person B is going to feel it's over, there's no victory to be had here, this is a lost case, well, they're going to be in for a surprise. This is wish fulfillment, person B. This is an Ace of Cups that is going to be offered to you, and justice will be restored, Pisces. Person B, if you remember the cards, Person A had the Justice card twice as their intention, right? And here it is, the Justice card. Things will be put right, I feel. I think this blockage period is soon going to be over. Person A is going to come towards Person B to try and work towards this connection again. They want to apologize. And just when Person B is kind of giving up hope, well, here comes happiness. Wow. All right. So best of luck. Let me know. Till next time then. Love and light. Take care. Namaste.